Okay, did everybody have a copy of the paper? Did you bring it, Ariel?
Yeah.
Good, that's good. Just want to make sure that everybody have a copy of your paper. Yeah, because we're going to use it. If you don't have a copy on your laptop, on your computer, it's fine. But make sure when you
a hard copy is better.
Yeah, hard copy is better because we will write something on it. Okay, nothing on your table, please. Nothing on your table, just your paper, just your the copy of your term paper. Okay. Quiz, quiz.
Yay, quiz.
Yeah.
A chance to demonstrate our knowledge. Right, Brian? This is a great opportunity.
No quiz. Just hand out.
Oh, really?
Just hand out. Two of you guys. Three. Four.
Oh, one more.
Okay. See what we have over today. Okay. Well, we already have a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun on Monday, right? So today's gonna be dry. Really, really dry. Gonna like lecture you the entire time. So keep you guys awake. I mean, you guys have to be awake. Well, you know what's going on in Thailand right now?
No.
No? We call Songkran. It's like it's the water fighting with water festival thing. It's a water festival. When you actually like fight each other with water. I use the word fight. We don't actually fight. We just like play with water. Just get other people here. So today the lesson is really dry. So I'm
gonna throw some water.
Splash you guys around with water. Just kidding. So you can be mad because that's my culture. You're welcome. All right. So good job. Who went to International Bazaar last night?
Not me.
Well, good job. Jose was one of the e-board members, did a good job at like preparation and everything. So very good. Did you see the Japanese dance at the end? Good job, Neil. That was so cute.
Thank you.
Okay. Alright. So anybody has any announcement? Good. Do we have anything on Monday?
No.
Turn in your papers Monday, not Friday.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah, take the weekend because we're gonna talk about how to fix them today thoroughly, and take the time to get them right. Turn in Monday.
Okay, Monday. This coming Monday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Monday, your paper has to be turned in. Sounds good.
We're starting the next topic.
Okay.
Literary. We're going to read poems starting next week.
Yay!
Poems! Poetry!
Okay, write it down on your planner or something that Monday the paper is due. Okay. Alright, I will have a very quick lecture. It's not actually a lecture, basically like we just read something with me. And then we'll group you guys together. Not like Monday that we did. We're not gonna group just like that. And then I will give you guys some more instructions. So for now, your paper in front of your table, I mean your desk. So that's good. Let's talk about how when you write your paper, you make a claim of something, right? You put not a fact, but like, oh, maybe you can call it fact if you claim that to be true or something like that. But you make your claim, Now, when you make your claim, you have to prove your point. When you make your point, you have to prove it. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm gonna let you guys know how about like that. There's two things. Supported facts and unsupported facts. Let's do it together. Good? Okay, if you look at the handout before I move on. Introduction, body, and conclusion. Which part that actually needs supporting ideas? Body?
Yeah.
You don't know, Angie?
Everything.
Well, you can put supporting idea in everywhere, right? You can put it in like your introduction, or you can put it in like in your conclusion. But you need your supporting idea, like really good evidence, like in the body. That's the most important part, that you need your supporting idea. Now let's read this together. Just tell me if it is supported or unsupported fact. Sounds good? Once you look at it, you will just get it right away. Maybe or maybe not. I don't know. Depends. Okay. The learning and teaching report show that incorrect punctuation caused the most problems for students in conveying meaning in their essay writing from this department. This is unsupported facts or supported facts?
Supported.
Somebody?
Unsupported.
Unsupported. You have to support your claim now. Okay, by the raise of hands, supported fact. Be confident, supported fact. Unsupported fact. Irene, why is that?
Because it does say the learning and teaching report, but we don't know what is the report.
Oh, that's a good point. But when I say like support, it's like here, yeah, it's from this place. This place say that. This place say something like this. So this is supported facts. Sounds good.
I disagree though. I think this is an assertion that's unsupported. The learning and teaching report showed that incorrect punctuation caused most problems for students in conveying meaning of their essay. Okay, this report showed that, but in what way?
Oh, right? I see.
Like, what's the evidence?
Good. We need more evidence, right? We're not talking about the evidence yet. We just talk about this claim. This person, this writer, claimed that learning and teaching the incorrect punctuation is a problem. It's from here. So it means that these students or this writer has a supported fact. But we're not talking about the evidence to support what report yet. You know what I mean? Okay. Good? Okay, the next one. Is everybody clear? I mean, is it clear? Are you guys okay? Are you sure?
No.
We're not talking about evidence yet.
Yeah.
We're not talking about evidence yet. We just talked about the fact. Just talked about anything at all. But if you say Dr. Margulis said this is not a supported fact, we have a supported fact that Dr. Margulis said is not supported. You know what I mean? Okay, no. Pichet. Say that this statement is a supported statement.
Yeah.
And I'm not the evidence, but I'm the source of the claim.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you know?
But the support for that statement, mm-hmm. that Pichet said this is a supported claim, the support for that,
mm-hmm.
would be the fact that 26 people or 19 people, mm-hmm. heard it.
Yes.
You know, 19 people said, Pichet said,
yes.
That supports,
yes.
the claim that he said that. So if he says, I didn't say that, we can say, oh, but Bebe, did you hear him say that? If she said, yes, I heard him say that, those are pieces of evidence to support that claim. Mm-hmm. So in this case, the Department of Student Services is a, it's a citation there. So it looks like a supported, the claim has some support, but what that support is still.
We still don't know what support, but we have it's the claim from this.
Okay.
Daniel says that University of Wisconsin, like River Falls, 2017, the most successful event was International Bazaar, right? So that is, the support is from Daniel. He claimed that, but we don't know, we don't have the evidence yet, but we just have the fact. But and it is supported by his claim. Do you know what I mean?
Makes sense.
Confused?
No.
We will get there. Yeah, we'll get there. Okay, Angie, questions? Okay. Writing academic paragraphs is the most important skill in academic writing. Therefore, many students seek assistance with their writing skills at university. Supported or unsupported claim? What do you think, Bebe?
Unsupported.
Unsupported. Because we what?
We don't have any facts.
Well, we have fact, but we don't know who says it.
Well, we don't know that it's a fact.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay.
Well, we don't know where it's from yet, right? So we don't know. So it's unsupported. We're not going to the evidence yet, you guys. Just keep in mind, all right? Keep in mind. Okay, that's, we have the third one. If you look at your handout, there's a third one right there. What do you think? Somebody read it for me.
Yes.
Bye? How about you read it?
Third one, where?
Yeah, the third one. The Australian Associations.
Oh, the Australian Association of Essay Writing, 2005, page 129. Claims that their research in five universities shows that students are required to write academic paragraphs in 90% of their assessment tests.
So that is the just an example of supported fact. Get it? You have some source. You have the source. All right? Okay. Now there's five types of supporting ideas or supporting details. Everybody memorize it. Give you like about 2 minutes. Counting now. Go ahead, look. 10 seconds. 10 seconds.
Okay.
1, 2. Okay. Face down. Paper, face down. Don't look at your paper. Oh no. Okay. Give me one.
Fact.
Quotation.
Fact.
Quotation.
That's
expert opinions.
Jerry actually like looked at it. Okay, one more time. Dan, what did you say?
Facts.
Statistics.
Example.
Expert opinion and
quotation.
What?
Quotation.
That's good, right? Okay, you don't have to like, you don't have to memorize all of that, like each of you just memorize one. Okay, all right, let's talk about it just a little bit. Example can be, is it coming out?
It's coming.
Okay, example can be very tricky. You have to make sure that it's like universal. If you wanna claim something like my experience, I went to China and everybody speak Chinese. That is what?
My experience
and it is universal, right? Yeah, like everybody can speak Chinese in China or something like that. My experience, your experience can be very powerful. Just keep in mind. If you wanna put your experience in your paper for Doug to read, it is going to be very powerful. If you talk about fake news, use your own experience, anything that you encounter about fake news. But we will talk about how to make it like credible. Sounds good?
Okay.
So a little tricky. Facts.
Wait, one thing though.
Yes.
Is when you're using your personal experience, you don't have to say, or you probably shouldn't say, this is just my experience.
Oh.
A lot of people say that, and you don't need to say that.
Okay, good. Facts. The grass is green. Very good. But is it green in winter? So be careful when you use fact. Cats are animal. Correct? Facts. But you have to make sure that it goes along with the with your paper too. Don't use the fact that dog can like what do you call like encounter, not encounter, but like disagree, you know, can like you have to defend your
contradict.
Yeah, contradict. All right, statistic. He asked us to put figures or something, right?
Chart or visual.
You can use that chart or visual to like support if it is a like statistic.
But remember that this, you gotta explain it. Don't assume the reader sees the same thing you see out of the statistic or chart or something.
You want us to write a different thing.
Say that again.
You want us to write a different thing compared to the figures?
Well, I mean,
explain.
So if you have a bar graph that shows, you know, five different sources of something, or, you know, fake news sources, why are you putting that there? How is that supporting whatever your claim is? Because we might not know. The reader, it helps to explain it to the reader.
I have a question. Your experience and the factors, what's the difference?
Your experience is your experience, your own experience.
Not fact.
It's not actually always fact.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like you can go to Thailand and say like the food there was terrible. That's your own experience. But yeah, I can't encounter, I mean, I can't disagree with you because that's your experience.
Personal.
But you have to, yeah, it's personal.
Personal.
But you have to make sure that you have a very strong evidence to show that the food in Thailand is not good.
Okay, because in my paper I wrote fake news, but it's also my experience.
Mm-hmm.
The fake news talk about the Chinese government. So I'm a citizen, so it's also my experience.
Okay,
so I don't know what's the difference between a factor or...
It is a fact. Fact is like general,
mm-hmm.
not just about Chinese people or Chinese government.
Okay.
That's your own experience.
Okay.
The example that I gave it to you about going to China and people speak Chinese,
mm-hmm.
that can be both, because that can be my experience, but at the same time, it is the fact that people from China speak Chinese. Yeah, but if you make it very clear, have to make it very clear that it is your experience. Sounds good? Sure? Okay. All right, okay. Quotation. Direct, summary, or paraphrase? Have you guys practiced paraphrasing?
Mm-hmm.
Have you done it?
I don't think we did it in here, did we?
Class, but
we do a summary kind of activity for a time.
Yes.
But you guys did it probably in 101, the paraphrasing. No? Oh, we should do something to paraphrasing.
Yeah, something to do.
Okay.
We did 101.
You did?
Yeah, we did.
Oh, okay. I think
oh, yeah,
you
we
should
did.
Have done it. But your facial expression was
okay. Class this way.
And the last one is the expert opinion. If somebody claims to be an expert, you have to make sure that that person accredited to be an expert. There are five numbers, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want you to mark down. I want you to write it down, which one is which. I mean, this can be personal experience, or this is statistics, or this is quotation, or direct quotation, or summary of paraphrase. Go ahead. Jerry, what is number one?
In its research project, the Literacy Foundation argued that the common punctuation errors caused problems with meaning making in student writing.
You read it, but what is the type of supporting detail? What type? Is it facts? Is it statistics? Is it quotation?
Opinion? Because the Literacy Foundation, I think, is a foundation, like it's formal institution.
It's a very formal institution, but when we refer to expert opinion, it means a person.
Okay.
What is number one, you guys?
Quotation.
Are you sure? Huh? Expert opinion? Quotation? What else? Joseph, what do you
quotation.
Think?
I'm sure. Quotation.
Facts.
Facts? No. Joel, what do you think? Whatever Joel say is right. Okay, Joel, give me something.
Quotation.
Quotation, correct. Yes. All right. Number two.
But I think it's not wrong to also think of it as an expert opinion.
It is not. Number two. Why is that?
Because of the percent.
Because it has 60%. Easy. All right. Number three. Bye.
Number three.
What did you say, Neil?
Experience.
Expert opinion. Yes. Yeah. Correct.
But it is a quotation.
but you have to be able to distinguish between the two. The more you write, you will be able to tell. Alright? Okay. Ready? Number four, Ariel. What do you think?
Fact?
Yeah. Okay, good. And number five, just one left. Personal experience. All right, okay, grouping time. I mean, there's one more thing about supporting and opposing idea. We can talk about it if we have time later. It's not our main focus for today, all right? Okay, go to your group. Get to your group. get to your group, you see your name with your peers. Guys, I'm gonna turn the lights on. Group, one group over here, one group over here, one group over here. Yeah. Move up. You guys,
I never heard of the
grammar. No,
we. That's a song.
Who doesn't have a group?
No, this is part of the
group. dinner. You guys
are
You don't have group? Baby, oh, Jen's not here and Zoomin's not here. So lonely here.
Oh, yeah, that's helpful.
Minjing, Jen is Minjing.
Jen is not here.
Oh? Georgiana? She's here.
Jen.
Oh, Jen is not here. Okay. All right. So, paper, if you have your paper, this is the instruction. First thing first, I want you to highlight. If you have highlighter, that's good. If you don't have it, just underline. Highlight main idea of each paragraph. Okay, the writer, your own paper, highlight the main idea of your paragraph. Okay, go ahead. Here's your paper, and you have thesis statement or whatever, but you just need to highlight main idea, highlight the main idea of the paragraph, of your paragraph. Yeah, on your own paper, highlight the main idea of each paragraph.
Sorry. I was thinking you asked me where did you buy this.
Are we good? Are we done?
Not quite. A little bit. About 1 more minute.
Oh, you're joking.
No, every paragraph that you can.
In your paper. Underline or highlight your main idea of each paragraph. Your body of your paper, the body of your paper should have main idea, right? At this point, if you don't have main idea, I'm gonna splash it with water. Just kidding. I have highlighters. Anybody want highlighters? Give you 1 more minute.
One,
Usually write your main idea. Your main idea, like each paragraph.
The first sentence
of each paragraph. So it shouldn't be like a, it shouldn't be a, like hard, right? But if you have main idea throughout your paragraph, I mean, then it will be a little challenging. Okay, shall we move on? Okay, now within your group. Within your group, you have your teammates, you have your groupmates. It just like switch to the left or to the right, doesn't matter really. Okay, do it right now. Okay, yeah, switch your paper. Okay, all right. You have this sheet, the evaluation sheet. It's fun, guys. It's really, really quick and very easy. The first question is, did the writer highlight main idea in his or her paragraph?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, which is this. So you just go circle yes. That's all. Okay. Okay. The second one. By the way, guys, you write the name of the paper that you are holding right now. Angie, who are you holding? Whose paper is that? Yeah, Bai. Just write Bai's name on that sheet right there.
That's on this page.
It's okay. Oh, that's okay. Jerry, write Joseph's name here. That is Mio, right? Is it? Are you good? Are you guys good? Okay. The second one, you will read, I will give you about 15 minutes to read the paper of that person. Read it carefully, don't worry about, like, don't rush, just read. No need to rush, I give you like 10 to 15 minutes. And then I want you to look at it, if that writer has like a supporting idea or the evidence, which is facts, statistics, quotations, expert opinion, or example and all in the paper that you are holding right now. So that, is it confusing?
Do you count?
Yeah, just count like, oh, when you read the paper of that person, for example, I think you're reading Bai's paper, right? Oh, you read in Angie's paper? Okay, when you read it, just look at it, and we just learn about supporting idea. If it is a fact, supporting idea, or it is a statistic supporting idea. And you just count, or
so,
if you find it, you just count.
So mainly to clarify,
mm-hmm.
They just need to go to the underlined
yeah.
sentence now.
Uh-huh.
And basically you're just looking at the rest of the paragraph and seeing, did this idea get supported, and how is it being supported in
yeah.
the paragraph?
Pick the underlying paragraph that the writer already underlined, and read that, and then read the entire paragraph.
Right.
Yep. Go ahead.
this is it. Yeah, it's the